Good evening, everybody. Welcome to another class. This is Alejandro Narbona on behalf of Inglés Corporativo. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you for being here. Everybody, please, with your cameras on, your names displayed, because I'm going to take attendance. You ready? Hola, Susana Cáceres Mendoza.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ana María Chacón de García.
Present.
Thanks. Carla Ivania Cabrera Serrano. Carla Ivania.
Present.
Where are you, girl?
Present.
Oh, I see you. I see you. I see you. Thank you. Nice hat. Deborah Raquel Soto Martinez.
Present.
Thank you. Edson Andoni Guzmán Andaverde. Not present. Fátima Ifigenia López Ramos. Fátima.
Present.
Thanks. Fernando Ernesto Cosme Morales.
Present.
Thank you. Héctor Eduardo López Varela.
Present.
Thank you. José Antonio Cubillas Hernández. José Antonio.
Present.
Thanks.
Present.
Thank you, José. José Saúl González Roque.
Present.
Thanks. Carla Enet Amaya Herrera.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Catherine Melissa Susana Campos. Present. Mariana Carolina Cisneros Reyes. Not present. Miguel Ángel Paz Landaverde.
Present.
Thanks. Mira Carolina.
Present.
Thank you. Don Alfonso Madrid Escalante. René. Not present. Elena Marisabel Álvarez de Chávez.
Present, teacher. Present.
Oh, thank you, René. What did I do? Give me a second. Me fui a saber a dónde la lista. Go back. Here I am. Okay. Elena Marisabel Álvarez de Chávez. Not present. Sabrina Mabeletín Castro.
Present.
Thanks. Sandra Elizabeth Soto Romero. Sandra. Ok. Se la tomo válida, solo que no le oigo, pero sí, ya me hice bueno leyendo present en las labios. William Alexander Ramírez Flores.
Present.
Thank you. Are you okay, guy? You good? You sound like sad. All right, just one moment. Sorry about this. Having a lot of issues with the list right now. Carlos Armando Duarte. Carlos Armando. Not present. Isela Liliana Miranda Espinosa.
Present.
Hey, thank you. Luis Umaña Orellana.
Present.
Thank you. Jocelyn Imelda Rivas Abarca.
Okay,
thank you very much. All right. Anybody who just got here? No? Okay. So let's get it ready. What was yesterday's topic, guys?
Present perfect.
Present perfect. That's right. Present perfect. When do we use present perfect?
We are talking about life experience.
Yeah, life experience, right? Now, you can also memorize the other one. I'm not saying that it's incorrect because it is correct. Okay, an event that is started in the past and may or not continue in the future, pretty much. Or incomplete actions. But in the base, life experience. Now, what about the structure? Affirmative structure.
Subject.
Uh-huh.
Does
have, have or has, and what is have or has? Is that the verb or the auxiliary?
Auxiliary. The auxiliary.
Correct. And then?
Verb in past participle.
Verb in past participle, correct? And complement. What about the negative? What, okay, let's change this. What is the only difference between affirmative and negative?
We add not.
We add not. Where do we add not?
After the auxiliary?
After the auxiliary, correct. There you have it. And what about the yes, no question? What is the only difference between the affirmative and the yes, no question?
Just change the auxiliary put first.
Uh-huh. We switch the auxiliary. Correcto. So we're going to have or has, the subject. And what do we have at the end? At the end, we have the question mark. How do we answer these type of questions? What is the yes, affirmative answer for these type of questions?
Yes, I have. No, I haven't.
Yes, I have. Or no, I haven't. Correct. And what about if we're talking about him, about a he?
Yes, he is. No, he has.
Yes, he has.
No, he hasn't.
Or no, he hasn't. Correct. So guys, when do we use have? What pronouns?
I, you,
we, they.
Correct. And when do we use has?
It,
he, she, it.
Correct. What is the only difference between a yes, no question and a WH question?
The WH.
The WH, right? And where do we add the WH? Mm-hmm. Where do we add it? ¿Dónde se le agregamos?
At first?
At the beginning. Correct.
At the beginning. Okay. At the beginning.
How do we answer these type of questions?
The answer affirmative or negative.
Uh-huh. With affirmative or negative. Remember, these are information questions, so you can say whatever you want. Okay. Now, using present perfect, can we say when?
No.
No.
That's right. We don't mention when it started. No mencionamos cuando empezó. Can we use time frames?
No. We can't.
Can I say I have studied today?
Yes.
Yes,
yes, we can. So yes, guys, we can use time frames.
Yes.
Right? Like, for example, words today, this week. Can I use next week?
No.
No.
No, that's future, right? Can I use last week?
No.
No. Yeah. That is past. Mm-hmm. Correct. Mm-hmm. Can I use this year?
Yes, because the year is.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. The year is not over. So etc. 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 We can use time frames. We don't say when. Now, did you come up with have you ever questions?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, don't worry about it. For the ones who did, good job. For the ones who didn't, you're gonna have some time. I'm gonna give you some. Okay, les voy a dar algunas. I'm going to give you some. But, where are they? Oh, here is the first one.
No, no sound.
Repeat it after me, please. Have you ever been on TV?
Have you ever been on TV?
What is the answer for this? Affirmative.
Yes, I have.
Yes, I have.
Now, this is the important part, guys. Remember, when you answer, you already comply with the structure. Ya cumplieron con la estructura. Ahora sí pueden decir cuándo. Se los digo en español para que no se me enchivolen. Okay.
Yes.
Now, have you ever been on TV? Si vamos a hablar de nuestra experiencia, ¿podemos decir cuántas veces?
¿Qué pasó, mi amor?
Yes.
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 Okay. Okay, okay. I'm the teacher. I'm the teacher.
Sorry.
Don't worry, don't worry. Bye, guys. Have you ever been on TV? Hay dos maneras de contestar. Bueno, hay un montón, la verdad, pero las dos más comunes son las siguientes. Ustedes dicen que sí o que no, contestándole yes, no questions. Después pueden decir, por ejemplo, ¿cuántas veces? I have been on TV twice. He estado en televisión dos veces. ¿Estoy diciendo cuándo? Am I saying when?
No.
No.
No. No. ¿Y si yo quiero decir cuándo, qué tengo que ocupar? Simple past. Porque si yo digo cuándo, es que voy a hablar de una en particular. Por eso lo ocupo en pasado. Okay. So, I was on TV like 14 years ago. Estuve en la televisión hace como 14 años. No le voy a decir por qué salí en la tele, pero ya. Yeah. So that's the point, guys. Ustedes. Never mind, I cannot tell you that. So that's the thing. Ustedes contestan yes or no. Luego, si quieren decir cuántas veces, hablando de su experiencia siempre, sí, pueden seguir ocupando este present perfect. Si quieren hablar de la vez que pasó, ocupan el simple past. ¿Estamos claros?
Por miedo de estrés.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Have you ever broken a bone? Repeat after me, please. Have you ever broken a bone?
Have you ever broken a bone?
Yes, I have.
Have you ever broken a bone?
No, I don't.
I broke my arm playing soccer. Right? I broke my arm playing soccer. ¿Se fijaron lo que hice? Contesté siempre con yes, no. Y luego estoy hablando de la vez que me lo quebré, porque solo fue una, fue esta. ¿Estamos?
Okay.
Are you cachai? Okay, next one. Have you ever cheated on an exam?
No, I haven't.
Y aquí pueden decir lo que ustedes quieran, ¿ok? Porque no lo han hecho. Nunca lo haría. I would never do it. I would never do it, for example. I will do it in the final test.
Right?
On the final test. So, como dijeron que no, ustedes pueden agregar cualquier otro comentario. ¿Estamos claros en cómo contestar?
Yes,
Charlie. Aha. Uh-huh. Okay. So this is what you're going to do, guys. I'm going to give you, repeat after me, please. These are the questions that you will answer, and then you can add some more. Have you ever been on TV?
Have you ever been on TV?
Para que lloren o para que se alegren. Have you ever broken up with someone? Have you ever called your boyfriend or girlfriend by their wrong name or husband, right?
Have you ever called your boyfriend or girlfriend by their wrong name?
Have you ever eaten frog legs?
Have you ever eaten frog legs?
Have you ever fallen asleep in class? Let me see. Where are the other ones? I have like 100 of these questions, guys. Have you ever ridden a horse?
Have you ever ridden a horse?
Have you ever milked a cow?
Have you ever milked a cow?
Have you ever milked
Have you ever fired a gun?
Have you ever fired a gun?
Have you ever fired a gun?
Have you ever
fired a gun?
Teacher.
Never.
Fired a gun.
All right. So here you can change it, guys. You can answer these questions if you want, or if not, you can come up with your own. Okay? But I want one person to answer, then the other one, then the other one, as fast as you can. We're going to work with this because of the topic. We're going to do it for about 15 minutes. Okay? And if you don't know the question, then you can ask. You can look for the word. Any questions? All right, so don't worry about writing, guys. This is just speaking, no writing. Speaking, no writing. Clear? All right, go for it. Accept the invite, please. All right, go for it.
Hello.
Hello.
So, Carla, have you ever broken up with someone?
Yes, I have. I broke. I broke up. I don't know. yes, I have.
Qué bonito, salimos de la zona de confort. Okay, so how do you say, sí, rompí con alguien hace 5 años, por ejemplo.
I broke up with someone 5 years ago.
Yeah, good. Good.
Well, William, have you ever been on TV?
No, I haven't.
One more comment. I'm shy, I don't like it, whatever, but always one more comment.
Ah, okay, no, I haven't. But I hope so. In the next.
Good, but I want to, right?
But I want. Mm-hmm. Next question.
Maybe in the next year.
Nice.
Okay, and have you ever called your boyfriend or girlfriend by the wrong name?
Cool. Miriam, Catherine, everybody participating.
Me aparecen, teacher.
Como no, ahí están. Negro. Lo que pasa es que hay que decirles.
Dígale, teacher. Miren, Carolina.
Ok.
Está.
Aquí estoy, ya viste.
Ya ve que está. Go for it.
Ah, yeah. Ok. ¿Have you ever called your boyfriend or girlfriend by the wrong name?
No, I have.
Okay. No, I haven't.
Yay. No, I haven't.
One more comment.
Because to my mom.
Because of my mom. Ah, that one que si le ha dicho el nombre equivocado a su pareja.
No.
Okay, no, I haven't.
No, I haven't.
And then.
Pero lo que le quiero decir que mi mamá sí se lo ha dicho a él.
Ah. But my mom has. Uh-huh. My mom has. Es como yo no, pero ella sí.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, got it. Good job, good job. That's what I'm talking about. All right, keep it up. Include Catherine too. One, 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 and you help each other. Go for it.
Okay. Catherine.
Beer se bea.
Beer se yes, yes, I have.
En licua.
Yes, I have.
Yes.
It's delicious. Frequently. No.
No, I haven't.
Okay.
Have you ever eaten squid?
Have you ever?
Eaten a squid.
Nesquik.
Uh-huh. No, squid. Squid.
Ah, squid. Ajá. Uh-huh. Yeah, squid is squid. Calamar. Ajá. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yes.
No, no, I haven't.
No, I haven't.
I don't like.
I am
I don't like what? How do you say mariscos? Seafood.
Seafood, exactly.
Uh-huh, seafood.
Seafood.
I don't like, I sick teacher. I am allergic.
Ah, okay. Okay. No, I haven't because I am allergic.
Allergic, yes.
Okay. Yes. Pero repítalo. No, I haven't because I'm allergic.
No, I haven't because I'm allergic.
I'm allergic.
I'm allergic.
Yes. All right, you're doing good. Keep it up.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever played the guitar?
Nice.
No, I haven't.
No, I haven't.
never instrument. Ningún instrument.
No instrument.
No
instrument. Y ustedes pueden decir, I have never played any instrument. Yes.
Any instrument. Okay. Okay. I have never played never instrument.
I have never played any instrument. All right. Good job. I like it. Keep it up, guys. Any questions?
No.
No? Always make another comment so you can practice more. Good job.
Thank you.
Excellent. Miran, they was competencia. ¿Cómo se dice la competencia? The competition, no.
It was a tournament, un torneo.
It was a tournament, ajá. A tournament NLC. El teacher debe recordar NLC.
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 NLC, yeah.
Sí. I remember. Uh-huh. NLC.
The Columbia Company.
Yeah.
Columbia Company. Sí.
I was working
20 years ago.
Columbia Company.
20 years ago.
Oh, you did. Oh, sí. Okay. Well, we can talk about that.
20 years ago. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Por eso estuve en la tele. Por eso estuve en la tele, pero con OBM, no con NLC. Okay, next. Have you ever broken up with someone? Have you ever broken up with someone? Ay, me cuesta decirlo.
No, I haven't.
No, I haven't. And always one more comment just for you to practice your English.
I play soccer, but no he sufrido, digamos,
an injury.
No me he quebrado. I haven't broken. I play soccer, but I haven't broken.
I never broken. Like this, I have never broken a bone or any bone. Now, the thing is this though.
I have never broken any bone.
Yeah.
Okay.
The only difference though is broken up is not when you break a bone. Broken up is when you finish a relationship. For example, with your boyfriend, with your wife. That's broken up. This is a phrasal verb. Es un verbo.
Yo eso iba a decir que no es de...
But I understand why that it is related. Porque broken es como quebrado, vea. Pero broken up, to break up, es cortar con alguien.
Cortar con alguien. In my case, yes.
Yes, I have. Never broken
Hi. Good job. Let me check another group. You're doing great.
Okay, gracias.
Okay, ¿qué dijiste, Hector?
What did you say?
Have you ever fallen asleep while talking about?
Well, a bath is in the hot tub. En la tina. Nosotros casi no tenemos tinas acá, ¿verdad? Pero.
A box.
No, I haven't.
And always add one more
en
comment.
La tina.
No, I haven't. I don't have a bathtub. No tengo una tina. I don't have a bathtub.
And Jose, have you fallen down the stairs?
Se escucha bien cortado.
Sí, no.
Have you ever fallen down the stairs? ¿Ya se han caído en las gradas?
No, I haven't.
And the comment? Siempre hay un comentario más. No es necesario. Practiquen.
Okay.
I have never, y ahí repiten, fallen down the stairs. Remember, in the question you have the answer, and the answer you have the question. I have never. Or he has never, she has never, and you repeat the question.
I have never
fallen down the stairs. Y repetís la pregunta, prácticamente.
With six first seat. Who is teacher?
Come again, please.
¿Qué significa first seat?
Which one? Can you write it down, please?
Have you ever fallen in love at first sight?
Oh, first sight. First sight.
Person.
Uh-huh. It's like you don't know the person. You see the person and immediately, I love her or I love him in case of women, right? First sight. Primera vista. Love at first sight. Okay, keep it up, guys. Okay. I'm gonna give you a couple more minutes.
Okay, Jose Antonio.
Okay, thank you.
Okay,
José Antonio, have you ever been on TV?
No, I haven't. No, I haven't. I would like to travel to USA with my sister. But I don't know when.
To the USA.
To the USA.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, let me try with another one. Have you ever watched a Korean drama? Sabrina or
Excuse me, can you repeat, please?
Yeah, have you ever watched a Korean drama?
No, I haven't.
What is that?
Sabrina? It's like a soap opera, but it's from Korea.
I don't know. I don't.
No, no entiendo. ¿Dónde está?
I'm going to tell you in Spanish. Es como un drama coreano, como novela.
I don't like
Stairs to the Heaven. You don't like it?
No, no, I don't like.
So you can say that. No, I haven't. I don't like it.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. When you say I don't really like it, it's like un poquito más suavecito. But I don't like it, right? No, you know what? I don't really like it. No me gusta more.
Okay, we cannot be friends.
Oh my God! Get this girl out of the breakup room.
Okay.
Any questions?
Okay. Actually, let me check. No, I think that we don't have question. I don't know if Carlos or Sabrina has.
Have.
Mm-hmm. I don't know why, but I always get confused with that, to use the have and has. And I have tried to memorize, and I was talking with my boss today,
mm-hmm.
but I always forget when use have and has. For example, I was not sure when you are talking about or teen, if you are going to use have or has.
Depends
because
if you're talking.
I'm including me.
I'm including myself,
yeah.
So that is
I include myself.
We have.
But yesterday, I think that we had an example that we use or team.
Yes.
And I think that should be has, right?
Depends if you're talking about the team one or if you're talking about the individuals.
Or not. I'm sure.
If you're talking about the individuals,
I couldn't hear you
have.
Because I don't know if the connection is wrong.
Can you hear me now?
Okay.
If you're talking about
I will try
the,
to practice that because
yeah.
I always forget it.
Keep on practicing this and then I can help you with that. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, keep it up.
Okay.
Okay.
Here it come. For example,
it's came. Have you ever came?
Came.
Have you ever came from room, for example? This is correct.
Have you ever came? Come?
Mm. Have you ever came? Come drunk, como has llegado borracho a tu casa. No sé.
What is the conjugation of come?
Have you ever
come? Came.
Came.
Came. Ah, es cierto. Came es el pasado.
Have you ever come? I'm drunk.
Y se pronuncia diferente el participio.
Participo.
No, tiene que ser otra pronunciación como el read, ¿verdad?
No, it's the same. Come, came,
same.
Come. Yeah.
Ah, okay.
Okay, it's correct, teacher. Have you ever come home drunk?
Oh, get drunk.
Yeah.
Got drunk.
Have you ever come home drunk?
Ah, can you ever come?
Yeah.
No, I haven't.
Okay, no, I haven't. Mm-hmm. I've never done that.
But the thing is that is very Spanishy. It's going to be, have you ever gotten?
Gotten.
To get home is llegar a casa.
Current drunk to get home. Sí.
So have you ever gotten home drunk?
Gotten home drunk.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, gotten home drunk.
Gotten home drunk. Ah, sí, es que quede como traducido literalmente.
Correct.
Aquí es más de...
Have you ever
Y ese que nos acaba de dar nos puede dar un montón porque es como alguna vez has llegado tarde al trabajo.
Yeah,
Gotten work later.
Gotten to work late.
Gotten to work late, ajá. Uh-huh.
Okay. So far, do you have any questions, guys?
No question.
Okay, so keep on practicing and we're going to be back. You still have 1 minute. Take advantage of it.
Okay. Had you ever sung in public? Sung.
Ah, sung in public.
Mm-hmm. In a karaoke?
Yes, I have.
Yes, I have.
Three years ago.
I sang.
Every Friday.
Sing, sang, song.
You can say, yeah, I did it 3 years ago. But after, yes, I have. I did it, simple past, 3 years ago.
3 years ago.
Sería como 3 years ago, I sang every Friday.
In this case, if it's a regular thing, it's simple present.
Yeah.
Oh, I see you. So in your case in particular, it's going to be, I sing every Friday.
I sing every Friday. Okay.
Why simple present? Because you already answered. Have you ever sung karaoke? Yes, I have.
I sing every Friday.
Como tú ya contestaste, ya luego de eso puedes decir lo que quieras en cualquier tiempo. Sí. Y tu mensaje es que lo haces siempre, lo haces cada viernes, ¿verdad? Entonces, ¿eso es un hábito o ocupas simple present?
Okay. Mm-hmm. No, yo, pero era three years ago. I don't know, three years ago. Hace 3 años. Era como hace 3 años lo hacía.
Yeah. In that case, you're going to be using this expression. I used to sing every Friday.
Okay.
Creo que ya lo cubrimos con ustedes. El I used to, ¿no?
Yeah.
I think so. I'm not sure. But I used to is solía.
I used to. Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right. Very good.
Yeah.
2 volunteers, guys.
Me, Sabrina.
Thank you. And the other one?
Me, Fernando.
Thank you very much. Okay. Sabri, ask Fernando. And once Fernando answers, he's going to ask you something. Go for it.
Okay. Have you ever driven a sport car?
Driven.
No, I haven't. The only car that I drove is the mine sería. Es mío. Is the mine in my car doesn't a sport car.
It's not a sport car. So say it with me, please. No, I haven't.
No, you haven't.
I have only driven mine.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. And it's not a sports car.
And it's okay.
Okay, repeat.
And it is a sport car.
There you go. Good job. Now you can ask Sabrina.
Sabrina, have you ever travel to Spain?
No, I haven't, but I would like to travel to Spain.
Okay.
All right, good job to both of you. Hey guys, cuando pida voluntarios se tendrían que estar peleando por pasar, porque solo así les puedo ayudar. Okay, no se escondan detrás del monitor. You can do this thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people without the camera. Come on. All right, 2 more volunteers, please.
Me, Ivania.
There you go, Ivania. And the other one?
Me,
Jocelyn. Jocelyn. Okay, good. Ivania and Jocelyn, go for it.
Jocelyn, I have ever...
Have you ever?
Have you ever exotic food?
Eaten?
Eating.
Exotic food?
Exotic food?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I have. One time I eat sushi.
Eight?
For me, it's an exotic food.
Okay.
Eight.
One more time, both of you. Have you ever eaten exotic food? Yes, I have. Once I ate sushi. For me, it's exotic. Go.
Yeah. Okay.
Carla, ask again.
Okay.
La misma pregunta, the same question. Have you ever eaten exotic food?
Have you ever eaten exotic food?
Yes, I have. One time I eat sushi, and for me it's an exotic food.
Good job. I liked it. I liked it. The only thing is, remember, eight.
Yes.
Don't worry.
I have a problem with it.
Vaya, ¿qué pasó ahorita? ¿Qué acaba de decir Jocelyn? Tengo problemas con eso. ¿Qué tiene que hacer Jocelyn? Ahora que ya descubrió, tiene que trabajar en eso. Como Carla. Carla había dicho al principio, I have. Y ahora ya sabe que es have you ever. ¿Qué tienen que hacer ustedes? Cuando hay una corrección, no sentirse mal, porque por eso, para algo estoy aquí, ¿no? Sino que ya saben qué es lo que tienen que mejorar, practiquen. Punto.
Okay.
No es para sentirse mal. Good job. Now, Jocelyn, you can ask Carla Ivania.
Okay, Carla Ivania, have you ever seen your favorite movie twice?
No, I have.
I haven't?
No, I haven't.
Uh-huh.
Repeat, please.
Okay. Have you ever seen your favorite movie twice?
Have you ever seen, look at me, seen
okay.
your favorite movie twice? ¿Qué entendió?
Que si he visto mi película favorita.
Twice. Dos veces.
Dos veces, ah, ok.
Ok, very good.
Ajá, ok. Yes, I have. I have seen many
times.
Many times.
I have seen it many times.
I have seen it many times.
Good job, Carla Ivania, and good job, Jocelyn. You see, guys, Carla Ivania, ¿fue fácil? No, vea.
No.
Ahí está, y necesito que practiquen, necesito que hagan eso que ha hecho Carla Ivania y Jocelyn. Solo así, ahora. Si ya después Jocelyn, perdón, en este caso Carla Ivania no lo anota, pues ya está en Carla Ivania, ¿no? O si, hey, tengo que mejorar esto. Vamos, guys, good job. That's what I like from you, that you need to participate. Y todo lo demás, estoy perdiendo el tiempo, no estoy participando. Claro que no. Cuando alguien más participa, ustedes también aprenden, sí ponen atención, no están en el teléfono. Right? O le vi la cara asustado a algunos, pero no, no era en directo. Sin querer. Pero sí necesito que se pongan buzos con eso. Repeat after me, please. I will be able to.
I will be able to.
Will be able to.
Make a phone call to report sickness.
Make a phone call to report sickness.
Do you often get sick?
Do you often get sick?
What are the procedures?
What are the procedures?
To report a work absence.
To report our absence.
One more time. I will be able to make a phone call to report sickness.
I will be able to make a phone call to report sickness.
Uh-huh. To report sickness. Do you often get sick?
Do you often get sick?
What are the procedures to report a work absence?
What are the procedures to report a work absence?
Great. I need a volunteer to read this, please.
Me and Maria?
Go.
I will be able to make a phone call to report sickness.
There you go. Good job. I need another volunteer to ask me this question. Just the first one.
Do you often get sick?
Not anymore. I used to when I didn't like my job, but not anymore. ¿Qué le acabo de decir?
Que solía enfermarse, pero ahora que tiene este trabajo ya no lo hace. Bueno, cuando tenía el trabajo anterior.
Ajá, porque no me gustaba, right? Okay. Y me enfermaba. Yeah. Me enfermaba. You know. Another person to ask this question. The second question, please.
What are the procedures to report our absence?
I have to contact my immediate boss or my supervisor. After that, I have to send proof or evidence that I went to El Seguro or I went to the hospital, and I have to send a picture of the medical leave if I have one. Medical leave. What is the meaning of medical leave?
Incapacitation.
Yeah. Okay, very good. I need another someone else to answer this question, please. Volunteer to answer these two questions. Who's that? Me. I heard me, but in the background. Okay, thank you. Hey, Jocelyn, do you often get sick?
I rarely get sick.
Oh, that's good. That's good. You're very healthy. And
no, I wish.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes. I wish to be sick.
Yeah, I imagine. Yeah. What are the procedures to report a work absence in your case, Jocelyn?
Well, in my case, I need to call to my supervisor to notify that I am sick and I'm feeling bad. I need to go to the east, and I need to extend the medical leave.
Okay.
And I need to.
So you need to call your supervisor.
Yes, call my supervisor.
Okay, very good. Nice process. Good job. One more volunteer.
Me, Ana Maria.
Ana Maria, do you often get sick?
I get sick once a year.
What is that? Interesting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And what are the procedures to report a work absence?
I go to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And I receive medical leave.
Uh-huh.
And I report with my boss.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Interesting. Pretty standard, right? Pretty standard.
¿Cómo puedo decir desde el año tal?
Since and the year.
And the year. 2040? 2040?
2040?
14.
Ah, okay, very good. Uh-huh. 2014.
Wow. Yeah. Chiku, Pika, Chiku, Sika, Sika. 5 years.
Oh my God. Okay, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Good job, Ana Maria. Thank you very much for sharing. The rest of you, please go ahead and repeat after me, please. Good morning. This is Mr. Ruiz.
Good morning.
Mr. Ruiz. Or Ruiz, if you want to keep it in the Spanish, Mr. Ruiz.
Mr. Ruiz.
Hello, Mr. Ruiz. This is Jenny. I have a situation.
Hello, Mr. Ruiz.
I have a situation.
Hi, Jenny. Tell me, what's the matter?
Hi, Jenny.
I'm not feeling well today.
I'm not feeling well today.
My stomach is killing me.
My stomach is killing me.
I'm as sick as a dog. Okay, I understand.
Okay.
2 days ago, I was feeling under the weather too.
Today, I was feeling under the weather too.
Oh, really? There's something going around.
There's something going around.
I hope you're feeling better.
I hope you're feeling better.
Oh yeah.
I'm in tip top shape.
Take it easy, Jenny. I hope to see you on Monday.
I hope to see you Monday.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Ruiz. Have a nice rest of the day.
All
right, let's do it together. You know the drill. Good morning. This is Mr. Ruiz.
Good morning. This is Mr. Ruiz.
Hello, Mr. Ruiz. This is Jenny. I have a situation.
Hello, Mr. Ruiz, this is Jenny.
I have a situation. Hi, Jenny. Tell me, what's the matter?
Hi, Jenny. Tell me what's the matter.
I'm not feeling well today. My stomach is killing me. I'm as sick as a dog.
I'm not feeling well today. My stomach is killing me. I'm as sick as a dog.
Okay. I understand. 2 days ago, I was feeling under the weather too.
Okay, I understand. 2 days ago, I was feeling under the weather too.
Oh, really? There's something going around. I hope you're feeling better.
Oh, really? There's something going around. I hope you are feeling better.
Oh, yeah. I'm in tip-top shape. Take it easy, Jenny. I hope to see you on Monday.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Ruiz. Have a nice rest of the day.
Translation services. Good morning. This is Mr. Ruiz.
Buenos días, señor Ruiz.
Soy el señor Ruiz. No es Esteban. ¿Y por qué no dice I am? Otra manera de decirlo. Hello, Mr. Ruiz. This is Jenny. I have a situation.
Hola, señor Mr. Ruiz. Soy Jenny. Tengo una situación.
Hola, Mr. Ruiz. Soy Jenny. Tengo una situación. Hi, Jenny. Tell me, what's the matter?
Hola, Jenny. ¿Qué pasa?
¿Qué pasa? ¿Se acuerdan de WhatsApp a la yuca? No sé si son suficientemente jóvenes. De aquí lo sacaba, me imagino yo. What's the matter? What's the matter? What's the matter? Right?
What's the matter?
¿Qué pasa?
What's the matter?
I'm not feeling well today.
No me siento bien ahora.
My stomach is killing me.
Mi estómago me está matando.
I'm as sick as a dog.
Okay.
I'm not feeling well today. No me siento bien hoy. Mi estómago me está matando. Sí, pero eso es literal. No es que literalmente el estómago lo esté puyando por dentro, sino que se siente mal, que le duele el estómago. Okay. I'm as sick as a dog. Estoy tan enfermo como un chucho. ¿Creen que significa eso? ¿Que se está comparando con un animal?
No.
Es como una expresión de, no sé.
Is this an expression for what? What do you think it's trying to say?
It's an expression to
comparación.
To say that you are unpleasant. I don't know what is the meaning, but it's como que unpleasant, yeah, with the situation.
Yeah, you're unpleasant.
That you are feeling not really bad.
Yes, that you are very sick.
You are very sick.
Estoy bien enfermo. Okay, I understand.
Entiendo.
Two days ago, I was feeling under the weather too.
Los días antes me sentía. También me estaba sintiendo mal.
También me sentía mal.
Me sentía mal.
¿Y qué significa under? What is the meaning of under?
Bajo.
Debajo. The weather.
El clima, pero es que.
Gripe.
De la patada.
Estaba bajo el clima.
Pero no, esa es una expresión también, ¿no? Que ellos me sentía mal también.
That's right. But under the weather means you have the flu.
Yo también me sentía mal.
The flu.
Oh, I think I'm under the weather.
I was right.
Fónica.
The flu, like you have the flu. Tiene gripe, ajá. Tos.
Ahora no.
Cualquier tipo de enfermedad que sea por, como por haberse mojado, por andar en el helado, etc.
Un resfrío.
Oh, really? There's something going around.
¿En serio?
Oh, de verdad.
Eso está, o sea, está rondando.
Algo de
está rondando.
Algo
está rondando.
Espero que te sientas mejor.
Hay algo dando vueltas.
Dando vueltas por ahí. Vueltas.
Algo está pasando.
Como dicen, algo viral. Cuando vas al seguro te dicen,
ajá,
es algo viral.
Exacto.
There is something going around.
Exacto. Como algo está pasando, en este caso, algo viral.
Ibuprofeno.
Right?
Ibuprofeno,
yeah. I hope you're feeling better.
Espero que te sientas mejor.
Mejor.
Espero que te estés
sintiendo mejor.
Oh, yeah, I'm in tip top shape.
Estoy en tip top shape.
Alrighty, guys. Let me show you something.
Tip top.
Let me show you something.
Tip top is como forma. Estoy recuperando la forma, no sé, tip top, como estoy.
Estar en forma.
Okay.
Estar en forma.
I'm going to show you, I really hope I don't get into trouble for this. But I'm going to show you this. Look at the way.
Estoy en la forma.
Espérese, sí.
Yes.
This is the way, guys, you can look for things you don't know. En vez de buscar solo tip, en vez de buscar top, en vez de buscar solo shape, tip top shape, meaning. Don't Google it in Spanish. Do it like this. Enter. Tip top shape. Let me see. Okay. The thing is this. I cannot access any of this. But try to keep a tip top shape by exercising every day. Even though our house is in tip top condition, we are having problems selling it. The hotel we stayed, it was absolutely tip top. So what do you think tip top is?
En buena forma.
En buena forma. En vez de estarlo buscando en español, búsquenlo así y se pueden meter en cualquier website, que yo no puedo hacerlo. Right? Y aquí les dice cómo usarlo. Así que en vez de estar buscando una definición, están viendo cómo se ocupa. Okay? Así les aconsejo que busquen lo que sea que estén buscando y seguido de la palabra meaning. It's going to help you a lot. All right, so in good shape. That's right. Let's finish real quick because I got to take attendance. Take it easy, Jenny.
Tómalo con calma.
Tómalo con calma, Jenny.
O sea, ¿creen que Yanni está molesta por algo?
No, no, pero preocupada. Entonces,
relax.
Relax. Tranquila.
What do you think take it easy is?
Tranquila.
Relájate.
But it depends. When it, hey, take it easy, man.
Calmate.
No.
Calmate.
Que te vaya bien.
Tómalo con calma.
Que te vaya bien. Salud.
Tómalo.
Hey, take it easy, man. Es una manera de despedirse. It's a way of saying goodbye.
Hasta luego.
Sí significa take it easy. Si yo estuviera bien bravo, if I were very upset, hey, take it easy, teacher, relax. Eso significa relax también. Pero en este contexto, como se está despidiendo, que te vaya bien, salud.
Right?
Clear on this one or confusing?
Yes.
All right. I hope to see you on Monday.
Espero verte lunes.
Espero verte lunes.
Espero verte lunes. Thanks a lot, Mr. Ruiz. Have a nice rest of the day.
Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias, Ruiz. Que tenga un
buen resto del día.
Tengo un buen resto del día. Correcto. Let me take attendance real quick, guys. Ana Susana Castro Mendoza.
Present.
Ana María Chiconde García.
Present.
Carly Bani Cabrera Sosano.
Present.
Débora Raquel Soto Martínez.
Present.
Edson Andoni Guzmán Landoverde. Not present. Pati Mifejenia López Ramos.
Present.
Fernando Ernesto Cosmo Morales.
Present.
Héctor Eduardo López Varela.
Present.
José Antonio Cubías Hernández.
Present.
José Saúl González Roque.
Present.
Carla N. Amaya Herrera.
Present.
Catherine Melissa Susana Campos.
Present.
Mariana Carolina Cisneros Reyes. Not present. Miguel Ángel Paz Landaverde.
Present.
Miriam Carolina Mozo Valdés.
Present.
Don Alfonso Madrid Escalante. Don Alfonso.
Present.
Thank you.
Present.
Rosina Marisabel Álvarez de Chávez.
Present.
Sabrina Mabaratín Castro.
Present.
Sandra Elizabeth Osorto Romero.
Present.
William Alexander Ramírez Flores.
Present.
Carlos Armando Duarte.
Present.
Isela Liliana Miranda Espinosa. Isela Miranda Liliana Espinosa. Come on, girl, you're gonna wake up, yo. Luis Sumaña Orellana.
Present.
Jocelyn Imelda Rivas Abarca.
Present.
Hey, good job, guys. Another. Yeah, we are missing two people, but they were never here. Los que no, nunca están, nunca se conectaron. Congratulations, thank you very much. This is the second, I think, second or third full house of the module. Good job to all of you. Thank you very much. Okay, let's continue. How to use idioms, part one.
How to use idioms.
How to use.
Or well.
How to use idioms. Part one.
Idioms are words or phrases which mean something different from their literal meaning.
Idioms are words or phrases
which mean something different from their literal meaning.
For example, to be up in one's ears in work means to have a lot of work.
Means to have a lot of work.
Volunteer to read this line, please. Go ahead.
idioms. Ah, esa parte, ¿verdad?
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay. Idioms are words or phrases which mean something different from their literal meaning.
Okay, continue.
For example, to be up in one's ears in work means to have a lot of work.
Good job. Thank you very much. Everybody, please repeat after me. As sick as a dog.
As sick as a dog. As a dog.
Under the weather, too.
Under the weather, too.
Mm-hmm. This one doesn't necessarily need to have the two, right? You can say, I'm under the weather. Two is optional.
Okay.
There's something going around.
There's something going around.
My stomach is killing me.
My stomach is killing me.
Take it easy.
Take it easy.
Can't afford to.
Can afford to.
Calling sick.
Tip top shape.
Mm-hmm. That's right. So we're going to be working with this today, guys. I want you to match. For example, as sick as a dog, and you need to find which one of these it is. All right, so work on it, and I want you to give me in group at least two new idioms related to being sick. Okay, related to being sick. Dos idioms más, terminen esto. Y después me consiguen dos más relacionados a estar enfermo y me van a explicar qué es. ¿Ok?
No,
Carlos?
No.
All right. What is the meaning of as sick as a dog?
From muy here. Enfermo.
My stomach.
To be very sick.
To be very sick. That's right. As sick. As a dog. And you're going to do the same with the rest. Under the weather, find it here. Le encuentran acá. But after this, you have to find two more idioms. Tienen que investigar. You have to do some research. Dos idioms más que tengan que ver con estar enfermo. Now, okay. Les digo, los idioms son de las cosas más abundantes que hay en el idioma. No se mareen ni pretendan memorizárselos todos. ¿Qué ejemplos de idioms me pueden dar en español? Salvadoreños.
Mi cabeza me explota.
¿Me va a explotar la cabeza?
Okay.
Migraña.
Migraña, right? You have a migraine. What else?
Coronavirus fingido.
Bueno, te lo acabas de inventar. Qué bárbaro.
No, I'm kidding. Informal.
Es como.
I'm kidding. All right. So, what other do we have? ¿Qué otros idioms tenemos en español? Estiró la pata.
Colgó los tenis.
Exacto.
Los tenis o colgó los guantes.
Corre que te alcanza.
Corre que te alcanza.
No la soco.
Esos son los idioms, guys. Y en inglés hay un montón.
Corta.
Igual que en español. Ok, so completen esto. Me buscan dos más. Vamos a trabajar por unos... No más de 10 minutos para que lo podamos discutir. Que después me tienen que hacer una conversación. You have to create a conversation after this using the idioms. All right? So go for it. Finish this. And two new idioms related being sick. Go to the breakout rooms. See you back in 10. I'm gonna make some changes. Yeah, got too many people.
I'm sorry, did you send a request for a role or not?
Want it.
Yeah.
I want it. I don't know why, but you're not in the previous groups. There you go.
Because I'm having internet issues, I'm sorry. Okay. I was trying to.
Hey, if you say I'm. By WhatsApp, anyway. If you say I'm sorry, I'm gonna kick you out of the group. No, I'm kidding. Did you get the invite, Isela? All right, she's stuck.
About you. Puro abuelo, la tomaste el dedo, me salió.
What?
Es importante. Vaya.
Go for it.
Okay. My stomach is killing me. To be very sick, as you guys have thought. To relax, to rest.
To relax, to rest.
Is take it easy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Take it easy. Mm-hmm. Not feeling well.
Este creo que va con el under the weather too. Or?
Under the weather too. Uh-huh. Don't have time to. Don't have time to call.
Remember to practice, all of you. I want to hear Catherine and I want to hear Miriam too. Catherine, by the way, there's an open spot today from 10 to 10:10 because yesterday was your turn. Do you want to take it?
Yes.
Okay.
Today.
Good. Yes. Get your questions ready then.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Go for it, guys. Continue.
Okay, permítame, voy a anotar. My stomach is killing me. Number two, or second, to be very sick.
Mm-hmm.
Está muy enfermo.
Uh-huh.
As sick as dog. As a dog. Three, to relax, to rest.
Take it easy.
Take it easy, okay.
Tranquilo.
Mm-hmm. Four, not feeling well. Not feeling well.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Many people have the same thing. Is the
calling sick. Many people have the same thing.
Number
three.
Yes. And the other, ya no la vi.
And number seven, many people have the same thing. Mucha gente tiene lo mismo. Yeah.
There is something worth around.
To fund the office.
¿En la siete cuál sería? And the seven.
Personas tienen.
There is something worth around. Esa que es algo viral. Mucha gente está haciendo lo mismo.
Ajá, porque dice que es muchas personas, entonces podría ser esa. There's something going around.
Y la otra es donde say you are sick.
There's something going around. Uh-huh. To phone the office.
Sería
el número 6. Ah, la de no puedo permitirme llamar por teléfono a la oficina para decir que estoy enfermo. Ajá. Uh-huh.
Como le insistiría. Entonces nos hemos equivocado. Don't have time to, es can afford to.
Ah, don't have time to.
Ah, espérame, espérame, espérame.
Sí, porque can afford to es como no puedo permitirme.
Uh-huh. Enfermar. Entonces ahí cambiarla.
Calling sick sería.
Sería la última.
No, porque fíjate que ya lo decís. Ya lo decís, mira. Si vos lees la frase, la número 8 dice. Para el teléfono en la oficina y decir que tú estás enfermo. Llama al teléfono para decir que estás enfermo.
Entonces la 8 es llamar por teléfono a la oficina para decir, para comunicar que estás enfermo.
Ajá.
Dejemos lo mejor si vamos con la 5. In great condition. Entiendo que condition. Me encuentro en buena condición, ¿verdad?
In great condition.
Or not. In great condition. There's someone going around. In great condition, en buena condición.
In great condition es en buena condición, entonces no puede ser él.
En perfecto estado.
In great condition es en perfecto estado.
Ah, perdón, estoy en perfecto estado.
Tip top shape, no.
La mejor forma, yo creo que es esa. Ajá. Es la 8. La 5 es la 8. Uh-huh. Tip top shape.
Ok,
don't have time to.
Don't have a time to.
No tengo tiempo para hacerlo. No tengo tiempo para. No tengo tiempo.
Can I afford to?
Can I afford to?
Seven, yeah.
Do you have the information in that order? Yeah. So we already finished with that information for another way to say that we are sick, right?
Yeah.
Okay, actually, I was trying to search about idiom related to be sick. And actually, I found what is the pronunciation, but it's to be at death doors, door, to be at death door. That's mean to be really, really unwell. And also I could find to feel out of sorts, meaning to feel a little bit ill. And let me check what else. As sick as a parrot, but I don't know the meaning. I need to search the meaning. And I'm sick to death. Oh, I don't know if someone else has another one or have another one. Sorry, teacher, if you are listening, but
I know. Just stop saying I'm sorry, girl. You say like 5 times in the same sentence. Relax.
Okay.
No, normally when you use indefinite pronouns like everyone, everything, no one, you use third person with those type of things. Write it down with indefinite pronouns like everyone, everybody, no one, anybody, everything has third person. Got it?
So.
Not yet, but I'm going to try to.
Have you ever seen the show?
Fine.
Everybody loves Raymond. Have you ever seen that show? Everybody loves Raymond. No?
No, I have not.
Okay. So the thing is that whenever you use everybody,
no,
you use third person. Everybody likes, everybody loves, everybody sings, everybody studies. It is always followed by third person. Everybody has.
Okay.
All right, keep it up.
Okay.
Uy, pero vamos a quitar, voy a dejar de compartir porque el teacher lo. Ya me lo puedo, ya me lo puedo.
Hey, it's not me, man.
No, yo sé, es, son políticas de la compañía.
Hey, chill out, man. Relax the cake.
Tenemos una consulta. En una oración vimos que decía, vale, la expresión es, I am sick to death of. Entonces, en la oración ocupaban el hat en pasado de has. De hat dos veces, juntos. Estaba mal escrito, ¿verdad? Hat.
No.
Y ella decía, she hat and no. O sea, suficiente.
That is a past perfect.
¿Se puede hacer eso dos?
Yes. She had enough. Don't worry about it. It's the past of present perfect.
Okay. Por eso es. Ajá.
The first hat is the auxiliary and the second hat is the verb in the past participle. So it is correct.
Ahí nosotros nos quedamos como que lo habrán escrito mal dos veces.
Yeah, no, it's fine.
Teacher, I like this expression.
Don't shoot the messenger.
I feel.
Huh? Which one?
I feel a little off colors today.
Okay, that's another one. Nice. You can have like a lot of things. The one that I wrote down here is don't shoot the messenger. Is, for example, whenever you said, hey, ahí viene el teacher, que no sé qué, ya me lo puedo. When I say don't shoot the messenger, it's like don't blame me, no me eches la culpa a mí. I'm just following InstaForbes guidelines, right?
Okay.
Don't shoot the messenger.
Don't shoot the messenger. There are thousands of idioms.
Ese es un extra. Ajá, otro.
Don't shoot the dog. No, the dot. A los patos, ¿verdad?
I don't know that one. Eso no me la puedo. All right, guys, we're gonna have one more minute.
Okay.
Oh, by the way, that's how you write it. She had enough.
Correcto.
Ella
sí,
ha tenido.
Ella ha tenido.
Ella ha tenido suficiente.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't worry. We're gonna have time for that structure.
Había un montón de verdad allá por allá donde.
Sí, yo creo que
donde pero,
está bien chido.
It's taking me, no sé si es correcto. I think really como me estaba.
Hello there, everybody. Let's get this done. Did you finish? Did you have enough time to finish?
No.
No? Okay, don't worry. That's why we are. So, volunteer for number one. My stomach hurts badly.
My stomach is killing me.
That's right. My stomach. Say it with me. Stomach.
My stomach is killing me.
It's killing me. Good. Number two.
A sick dog.
Very sick.
Number two.
A sick dog.
That's right. As sick as a dog. Correcto. Number three, to relax, to rest.
Take it easy.
Correct. And what is the other way of using take it easy? What is the other
goodbye?
Relax.
Goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye.
To say goodbye.
That's right. Hey, take it easy, man. No es que se vaya relajado, sino que... Alu. Not feeling well.
Not feeling well? Mm-hmm. Under the weather too?
Under the weather too?
Yeah, okay. This one, you're going to use it with the verb to be.
Oh, under
to be.
The
under the weather. To be under the weather. How do you use, okay. How do you use this? Hey, I am under the weather. Right? He is under the weather. She is under the weather. Number five, in great condition.
Tip-top shape.
Tip-top shape. Correct. You got it. Don't have time to?
Can't afford to.
All right. Afford is, for example, you can use it when you don't have time to do something. For example, I can't afford to do the homework right now. I can't afford to do the homework. No la puedo hacer ahorita.
No puedo.
Right? But it's not only about time. No solo acerca de tiempo. También es que ustedes no se lo puedan permitir. So guys, you can't afford to lose this opportunity with the classes. Right? No te puedes permitir, thank you, perderte esta oportunidad con las clases. You can afford to lose your job. No puedes permitirte perder tu trabajo. So it's not only about time, no solo acerca de tiempo, but it's also something you cannot allow. ¿Se acuerdan de it's not allowed? Mm-hmm. Allowed es permitir, ¿vea? Entonces, no te puedes permitir algo. Y también el otro, guys, es the pistol. To afford es que no lo pueden pagar. I can afford, solo que aquí no estaríamos ocupando verbo con esto, ¿vea? Pues, to plus verb. I can afford to lose these classes. Si no tienen pisto, I can't afford an Audi yet. I can't afford an Audi. Si ustedes lo ponen después solo con el noun, es que no lo pueden pagar. ¿Ok? ¿Estamos claros?
Okay.
No.
No mucho. Sí, ya los vi a todos ahí con cara de tu parte. Ok, no puedo comprar una casa en Santa Elena.
No, it's very expensive.
Yeah, so how do I write that?
House.
I can't afford
a house in
Santa Elena. Bye, no aplica el bye.
I
can't afford a house in Santa Elena. Entonces prácticamente es complemento porque el verbo es afford. ¿Ya? Que no se lo pueden, que no tienen tiempo para algo, que no lo pueden pagar o que no lo pueden permitir. No puedo pagarme un iPhone 12, no sé ni por cuál van.
I
can afford an iPhone en general, ¿verdad? No tengo pisto ahorita. I can afford an iPhone. No me puedo comprar un Tomahawk. Tengo hambre. I can't afford a Tomahawk. Right? No me puedo comprar, no sé, digamos que andan $2 y ustedes quieren un combo del BK, por ejemplo. I can't afford BK.
Ya, hoy vale, creo que ya valen $3, ¿verdad?
Right? ¿Estamos claros con esto, guys?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Y el otro es I can't afford to y el verbo. Esto puede ser que no tienen tiempo o que no se pueden permitir. I can afford to lose this opportunity. No me puedo permitir perder. Esa es la diferencia. El anterior iba seguido de complemento. Este va seguido de verbo.
Claro.
Bueno, también es complemento, pero para darles la idea. I can't afford to. Dígame algo que ustedes no se pueden permitir, una acción que no se puedan permitir.
Levantarse tarde.
I can't afford to wake up late.
Don't go to the job.
I can't afford, como es negativa, not to go to work. I can't afford not to go to work. No me puedo permitir no ir al trabajo. Como yo, servicios profesionales. No class, no money, yo. Right. You got it? Next one, number seven.
Many people have the same. There's something wrong.
There's something going around.
Mm-hmm. And the last one?
Calling sick.
All right, guys. Now, the first group, which is, give me a second. Breakout rooms. Carla, Catherine, Miriam, and William, give me your new idioms, please.
To feel like death.
Okay. Group number two. Ada, Carla, Fátima, Roberto.
In the usual and the hospital, Tempe, teacher, tomar un refrigerio.
That's good in Spanish, but what about in English? Did you get it? Or you didn't have time? No?
No worries.
Which one, Roberto?
Spelling head Dutch.
How do you write it down? How do you spell it? How do you spell it? ¿Cómo se letrea?
Splitting.
Do me a favor. Good Spanish, Dutch. Man. Write it down in the chat. Write it down in the chat.
Okay. Not right now. WhatsApp group.
Okay, is it in WhatsApp or is it in here?
WhatsApp.
It's sounded true. WhatsApp.
I-N-G. Split.
Let me go to WhatsApp. Okay. Somebody send it to the chat because I can't. Sorry about this. Give me a second, please. I'll be there. Ah, splitting headache. Uh-huh. Split. What do you think is the meaning of a split when you hear banana split?
Dividir, partir.
Dividir, partir, right, guys? El inglés está un montón y ni siquiera nos damos cuenta. Banana split, una banana partida. So, splitting headache, siente que se le va a abrir la cabeza. Good job. Now, this is what you're going to do, guys. How many idioms did you find?
A lot.
Correct. And you don't have to memorize them all. All right? So, what I wanted to do, guys, is you're going to have 10 minutes for you to create a conversation. And I need you to include in that conversation two idioms per person. Okay, two idioms per person in one conversation. So let's say if you are four people, how many idioms are you going to use?
Eight.
If you are three people, how many idioms are you going to use?
Six.
How many idioms each person?
Two.
All right. Remember, easy. Let me show you something real quick. I'm gonna improvise. Hey, Alejandro, how are you doing? Man, I'm sick as a dog. Don't get close to me. Don't worry, I'm under the weather too because there's something going around. Yeah, and also my stomach is killing me. You have to rest, take it easy. You can't afford to feel that bad. You know what? I'm going to call in sick until I am in tip-top shape. Soy fácil, ¿no? Me pasé prácticamente de uno a lo otro. No necesito que me hagan las grandes conversaciones, sino que ustedes tengan la capacidad de hacer eso, de pasar de uno a otro con el mismo contexto, sin tanta cosa en medio. All right?
Okay.
Go for it, guys. I'm going to see you back at 9:45 to take attendance. Go. Okay,
I am sick to death. I can't work. I can't do my activities. I'm tired of this. Ya te dije dos nada más, pero le agregué. O sea, le dije que cuando dice as sick as a pug es como que estoy bien enojado. Y que I am sick to death of it, que ya estoy cansado de lo mismo. De algo, o sea, estoy cansado de que no sirva esa cosa y por eso estoy enojado. Al mismo tiempo ya ocupé las desesperaciones, por ejemplo.
Ok, entonces te podría decir, oh, yeah, man, you can afford to that continues to fail, for example, or you call a technician, or you can call a technician.
Pero eso no es un... Buscamos uno más, porque hay que unir las cosas.
No, por eso. Can afford, can afford.
O sea, can afford está bien. Eso sí,
que no te puedes permitir, vea.
Ajá, no me puedo permitir seguir así o llamar a un técnico.
Y lo otro que encontré es como que todavía está viva tu abuela.
De verdad. Qué raro.
Y el idioma sería, it's still alive and kicking. Si todavía está viva y coleando. No sé si está bien eso.
It is okay. And the opposite of that is to kick the bucket. To kick the bucket. Eso es morirse.
To kick the bucket.
Okay. To kick the bucket. Ajá, como patear el cuchumbo.
Something like that. Sick as a sparrow. Okay, I was able to found 2-3, but I don't know if I can use it. As sick as a sparrow.
This is Rina.
Siempre ocupamos el this is Rina.
Sí, yo soy Rina.
Good morning, this is Rina.
Vamos a cambiar. Vamos a cambiar.
Mejor que, cambiémoslo mejor.
Hello.
Sí, cambiémoslo.
Solo hello. Good morning. This is Rina, nada más.
No. No, my name is Rina. My name.
Okay.
Pongámoslo así.
I am Rina.
Thank
you. I am Rina.
Y ahí quién seguiría, puede ser cualquiera de nosotros.
Sí, cualquiera.
Hello, Rina. Hello. This is Hector and José Antonio.
Algo que me sienta mal, quiero ver. I am very sick. My health. No sé cómo se escribe esta palabra, déjame buscarlo.
Okay. Voy a hacer mis líneas.
¿Qué palabra es, Ana María?
Explotar. My head is going to explode. Uh-huh. Explode, no se me acordaba cómo se escribía.
Uh-huh. Entonces, decís, I am very sick. ¿Y qué uh-huh. te respondería?
My head is going to explode.
My head
is going to explode.
Done. Okay. Explode.
Y ahí qué me podrías contestar tú.
Podría contestarte, oh, I'm really sorry. In my case, I feel sick too. I'm feeling the world for work. Que sería muy cansada y en malas condiciones.
Vaya, ¿y qué más le agregamos ahí?
Veamos qué más.
También.
Quiero ver. Es por el clima, ¿verdad? ¿Eh? No, don't worry. Don't worry. Under the weather, ¿verdad? ¿O no?
Under the weather.
Ajá. Puede ser por el clima, pues.
Yeah.
I guess there you can use there's something going around perhaps.
Oh, también, teacher. Mm-hmm. Es que todavía nadie se ha enfermado, solo yo. Bueno. ¿Sí? There is something going around. Yes. Hello.
Yeah, you can use that one. Hey there, let's take attendance real quick so you have a couple more minutes of practice. Ada Susana Cáceres Mendoza.
Present, teacher.
Ana María Chocón de García. Ana María.
Present.
Cardivani Cabrera Serrano.
Present.
Débora Raquel Soto Martínez.
Present.
Edson Andoni Guzmán Landaverde, not present. Fátima Efeña López Ramos.
Present.
Fernando Ernesto Cosme Morales.
Present.
Héctor Eduardo López Varela.
Present.
José Antonio Cubillas Hernández.
Present.
José Saúl González Roque.
Present.
Carla Yaneta Maya Zara.
Present, teacher.
Catherine Melissa Susana Campos.
Present.
Mariana Carolina Cisneros Reyes. No. Present. Miguel Ángel Paz Landaverde.
Present.
Miren, Carolina Mozo Valdés.
Present.
Don Alfonso María Escalante.
Present.
Don María Isabel Álvarez de Chávez.
Present.
Sabrina Mabeletín Castro.
Present.
Sandra Elizabeth Soto Romero.
Present.
William Alexander Ramírez Flores.
Present.
Carlos Armando Duarte.
Present.
Isela Liliana Miranda Espinosa.
Present.
Luis Umaña Orellana.
Present.
Jocelyn Imelda Rivas Abarca.
Aprovecho.
Jocelyn.
Present.
Okay, good. Guys, remember, lo más fácil que puedan, pueden ocupar esa lista, okay? No necesitan andar buscando más, de un idioma al otro, solo con un par de palabritas, únanlo, I'm going to give you around 4 more minutes and everybody's going to come to the front or participate. Mm-hmm. Right? Rapiditos, cositas de 20, 30 segundos. Go for it. Go, you got this. 4 or 5 minutes more.
Ajá. So, va, comienzo, digamos, William, you look bad.
I know, I feel as sick as a dog.
You know what? I feel under the weather. I'm going to be my boss. I'm going to call my boss. Hello, Catherine.
Hi, Carla.
I feel from the kick.
Okay.
Can I take it the day?
There's something going around because other people, they have also reported that they feel bad. So take it easy.
Carla. Thank you, Catherine.
Welcome.
Bye.
Hasta
Good.
Don't leave anybody behind. Good job.
Okay. Miriam puede decir es...
Cuando digo, okay, Ada, there's something going around.
Take it easy. O puede ser que usted me diga, le trasladaré la llamada al
doctor.
Jefe. Okay. No, o al jefe, para que él mire, me diga, take it easy. Tómalo con calma, pues, y te vemos hasta el lunes. ¿No? Como okay. Él dijo, lo más corto que sería, se pueda, ¿no? No.
Yeah.
O sea, como estamos reportando que estoy enferma, ella me dice que también se está dando el mismo problema en la alrededor, pero que me va a comunicar con usted, que es el jefe.
I will happen to the boss.
Ajá.
Ajá. Y ahí le digo yo, take, vaya.
Hello, hello.
Ajá, pues vamos a...
Hello, Beth. Hello, good morning. I am Ada Cáceres. I call in sick.
Hello, Ada. Good morning. What happened?
I am have the joint pain are killing me.
Hi, Ana María, how do you feel today? And digo, I am really, cuando me contestaste, no es así que tú te ves.
Va, espera, me repetíme lo primero. What do you see?
No, how do you feel today?
I feel, es que no entendí eso. What do you feel today? Okay. Es how, ¿verdad? How. Uh-huh. Sí. Tengo mal oído, ya me di cuenta. How do you feel today? Okay. Ya de ahí entonces yo ya te contesto. Ay, very sick. Okay. Uy.
Okay.
Luego
yo respondo a Victor. In my case, I feel a color. Ay, ¿cómo se pronuncia?
Sí. Yo no sé bien qué es.
Which one?
My color. ¿Cómo se dice? ¿Qué dice?
Write it down in the chat. Write it down in the chat, please. So
okay.
I know
how to
say it. I will do it. Off color. That one.
Off color, like that.
Off color. What is it?
The meaning is you don't feel yourself, but you are not sure what do you have.
Mm-hmm. You're not sure what you have.
What you have? Oh, yes. They always include so many preposition. What about this one that you already sent you? Worse for wear.
Worse for wear.
Huh? The meaning is very tired and in a bad condition.
Good. Keep it up. You got like 2 minutes.
True.
I hope it's true and that is not a jacket, me sale casaca.
No. But it's not.
No, o sea, ah, pues hay que decirlo así como se dice, normal, casaca.
Mentira, mentira. No.
Ajá, mejor mentira.
Mentira. But he's not giving us a lift.
Lie.
Lie.
Mm-hmm.
That is not lie.
But then, how is your mother or your grandma? And you can mm-hmm. respond with the information that you already have.
Yeah, so, yes, I so, she is alive and well.
I'm sorry.
Cuando tú me preguntas eso de si está viva mi abuela o
okay.
Eso es lo que me preguntaría, va. Eso es lo que me preguntas.
Sí, porque es lo que usted quiere que le preguntes.
Hey, va, entonces después de eso yo te preguntaría, yes. Is she is still alive and well? Sí, todavía está viva y coleando. Eso es lo que te voy a responder.
Ah.
Okay, ya después tú me preguntas por lo de la que vaya a salir a hacer, o si voy a salir, qué más voy a hacer este día, o algo así.
What are you going to do today?
Ajá. Y yo okay. Te voy a decir, I was thinking of going for a room. Estaba pensando si le voy a correr. Y tú me preguntarías, oh. ¿Está ready? Y yo te voy a contestar la otra, el otro cosa. No me trabo todo.
I don't know if I'm going to remember, so let me write it down. Okay, do you mean that I'm going to ask you about your grandma, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's do it. Group number one, Carla, Catherine, Miriam, William, go.
William, you look bad.
Yeah, I feel as sick as a dog.
You know what? I feel under the weather. I feel from the kick. Maybe I am going to call my boss. Catherine, hello.
Hello, Carla.
I really awful. I feel awful. Can I take it today?
There's something going around because other people, they have also reported that they feel bad. So take it easy.
Thank you, Catherine.
Okay, you're welcome. Miriam, can you help me? Because Carla won't come to work. She's sick.
Yes, I came. The last week I was sick. By now, TikTok check is came for me.
Okay, thank you, Miriam.
All right, good job to all of you. Good job. I liked it. Was it difficult?
More or less.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, don't worry about it. Good job. I liked it. Ada, Carla, Fatima, Roberto, go for it.
Okay. Hello, good morning. I am Ada Cáceres. I call and sick.
Hello, Ada. Good morning. What happened?
I am a head and the joint pain and the killing me.
Okay, Ada. There's something that I'm going around. Give me a second. I will pass the call with the boss.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Hello.
Hi, Ada.
Hi, boss. I am a call and I call and sick.
Take it easy, Ada. You already went to the doctor?
Yes, boss. Yes, and the medical line and me for the 3 days.
Okay, Ada. See you Monday.
Okay, boss. Thank you. Only teach.
Okay. Good job. Clear and concise.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Good. the only thing though is whenever you say did you went to the doctor, it's gonna be did you go. Did you go? Mm-hmm. Ocupamos el verbo base siempre que hay auxiliar did. O sea, en afirmativo y en, perdón, en pregunta y en negativo, vamos a poner el verbo base porque el did ya está en pasado. Good job. Ana María, José Saúl y Jocelyn, go for it. Ana María, José Saúl y Jocelyn, go for it.
María.
Excuse me, no tenía mute.
Qué batalla con el botón de mute. Démosle pues.
No, espéreme, teacher. Es que hasta uno se lo pude poner y no vaya. Encuentro su número. Vamos. Ahorita se lo pongo aquí en este chat, Saúl.
Vaya, pónganse de acuerdo. Voy con el grupo 4 mientras ustedes se ponen de acuerdo por el tiempo. Héctor, José Antonio, René, Rina y Sandra, go.
Good morning, I am Rina.
Hello, Rina. This is Sandra, José, René, and Héctor. We have a situation.
Okay, what is the situation?
We're not feeling well today. Stress is killing us.
Okay.
We are feeling like a box.
Okay. Relax the cake. Don't feel so worried. Overtime will be paid at the end of the week. Thank you.
Express. Good job. Good job. Oh, do you still have something, or are you finished?
Finish.
Good job. I liked it. Relax the cake. I think it's very Latino. It's not a thing, but I like it. I use it. Carlos, Isela, Sabrina, go for it.
Hi, Isela, how are you?
Actually, I'm feeling really bad. My stomach is killing me, and I feel like I should be at death door. But I hope to get better soon, from top to toe.
From top to toe, yeah.
Yeah. What about you? How do you feel today?
I don't feel good in this moment. I have a problem. But you know what? A blessing in disguise, and I take it easy. Well.
Sounds great. What about you, Carlos? How is your grandma?
Hi. My girl is oh, sorry. My grandma is still alive. My grandma.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, really? Yes.
What a surprise. Yes. Is,
oh, really? Because she is
still alive and well.
Oh, okay. And what are you going to do today?
I was thinking of going for a room.
And are you ready?
Ready? I feel a fit as a violin.
Nice. Good job. Round of applause to you. Round of applause. Good job. Okay. We still have time. It's already 10:01, but I need to hear two groups. Deborah, Fernando, and Miguel. Go for it.
Okay. Hi, guys. I feel really bad. My head is killing me, and I am as sick as a dog. I went to the doctor yesterday, and it didn't help me. I feel from the kick.
No. Really, Miguel? I feel bad, too. I am under the weather. There is something going around in the office. We need to get rest.
Take it easy, guys. You should call in sick. Your boss will understand you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. I'm dying.
Nice. Express, too. Good job. And Ana María, José, and Jocelyn.
Okay.
Hi, Ana Maria. How do you feel today?
Hi, Jocelyn. I'm very sick. My head is going to explode.
Oh, I'm really sorry. In my case, I feel off color and word for wear.
Saul, can you recommend something to me?
Sorry, no, I can't. I am play soccer. I am very what? Easy.
What? Are you listening to me?
Yes, I am all ear.
Nice, I am all ears. Le valió porque tenía que jugar fútbol. Round of applause, guys. Round of applause. So before I let you go, I just want to say something. Los idioms son muy útiles. Por eso es que a veces no se le entiende mucho a cuando vemos películas y todo, porque ocupan demasiado. Por ejemplo, a mí me gusta Better Call Saul. Y Better Call Saul tiene una infinidad de idioms que en toda la serie. Así que no se frustren con esto, simplemente poquito a poco, frases que van a ir aprendiendo y así van a lograr una riqueza de vocabulario que les va a ser muy, muy útil en el futuro. Thank you very much for doing your best. I hope to see you all tomorrow. Everybody but Catherine, get out of here. See you tomorrow. Okay. Have a good night.
Good night. Bye.
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 Everybody hitting the red button. I'm going to stay with Catherine. All right.
Okay.
Dígalo. Tell me, girl.
No eran más que todo preguntas, sino que como un refuerzo. Estaba verificando el tema que vieron ayer. Del okay. Have y el has. Tenía entendido que el have es para I, you, we, they, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Y el has es para he, she, it. En este caso estaba viendo, estaba haciendo como unos ejemplos o algo así, pero se usa con los verbos en participio, ¿sí, verdad?
Sí.
Pero tenía una duda, no sé. Por ejemplo, he comprado una camisa nueva. Uh-huh. I have bought a new shirt.
Yes.
En este caso... sería necesario que lleva el have, no se podría poner solo como el bought. No sé si hay como algún orden gramatical o algo así que lo lleve, o necesariamente tiene que llevar eso, el have.
Buena pregunta, Catherine. Vaya, lo que pasa es que acá el have está funcionando como auxiliar. No sé si viste el video de la clase pasada, te explico rapidito. El presente perfecto se ocupa más que todo para hablar de tu experiencia de vida. Uh-huh. Ahora yo te pregunto, ¿has ido a la feria?
Yes. I have to say.
I have gone.
Uh-huh. I have gone. Ajá. Okay.
Entonces, ¿has comido pupusa loca?
No, I have eaten.
I haven't eaten.
Ajá.
Entonces, es eso. Cuando yo te pregunto en español eso del ¿has hecho tal cosa? Ajá. Yo te estoy preguntando si esa actividad ha sido parte de tu vida. Entonces, el have y el has hace la misma función que en español, el has. ¿Ya? Entonces yo te estoy preguntando que si ha sido parte de tu experiencia, por eso yo les digo que es life experience. ¿Ya has comido tal cosa? ¿Ya has ido a tal lugar? ¿Ya te has caído de las escaleras? ¿Ya te has quedado dormida en el bus? Etcétera. Uh-huh. Entonces ese has es el mismo auxiliar que ocupamos en inglés. Por eso sí tiene que ir el have y el has. Okay, no sé si estamos claros con eso.
Sí, ahora sí.
Okay. Entonces, con este prácticamente a nosotros no nos importa o no es la función de esta parte gramatical, no nos importa cuándo. Yo solo te he preguntado si ha pasado o no. ¿Ya? Entonces, okay. Hasta el día de hoy, si tú lo vas a hacer o no, en el futuro eso no nos importa. Así que no puedes decir cuándo, porque esa es la diferencia que tú me pones al principio. I bought a new shirt. Yo compré.
Ok.
Ya eso es pasado.
Ya es pasado. Decir,
¿no? Ayer, I bought a new shirt yesterday. La compré ayer. Si tú me dices, he comprado una camisa nueva, que se oye bien españolete, tío. Nosotros casi no lo ocupamos así. He comprado una camisa nueva. Ah, no, hombre. Yo te puedo preguntar, ¿dónde? ¿A qué horas? Pero no, el énfasis no es cuándo. Puedes decir cuántas veces, puedes decir dónde, etcétera, pero no ocupas énfasis en cuándo.
Ok. Pues quiero ver. Y, igual, ¿verdad? Siempre sería para la pregunta el switch, ¿verdad? Del primero sería el have, has, y ya luego sería el sujeto, ¿verdad? En este caso, como siempre en todas las estructuras.
Uh-huh. Ahorita en WhatsApp te estoy mandando prácticamente copy-paste del chat de ahora. No sé si lo puedes leer ahí real quick.
Yes, ahorita.
Entonces, ahí necesito que medio analices. Está la estructura, el have es auxiliar.
Auxiliar.
Y el verbo en pasado participio es, por ejemplo, comer, comí, comido. He comido tal cosa, no he comido tal cosa. Bailé, bailar, bailado. No he bailado salsa, jamás en mi vida, por ejemplo. A la pregunta, como tú puedes ver, solo se le da vuelta el have o el has con el sujeto. Lo mismo que todas las estructuras. Se contesta con el auxiliar. Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Yes, he has. No, he hasn't. Ahí te pongo para qué se ocupa el have y para qué se ocupa el has. Y las WH. Es que eso, creo que fue antes que tú te conectaras. Y las WH, como en todas, ¿vea? Solo se le pone la WH al principio.
Al principio.
Y es la misma estructura que la yes, no.
La yes, no questions. Okay.
Ahora, ahí te digo, we don't mention when it started. No mencionamos cuándo empezó. Podemos ocupar ventanas de tiempo. Por ejemplo, he hecho ejercicio ahora.
Ay, ajá, eso estaba viendo en unos ejemplos que va como I always have. Así, ¿verdad? Ajá, ¿qué son esas ventanas de tiempo que me comento?
Muy bien. He comprado mucha comida esta semana.
Okay.
Me he portado bien este año. Entonces, ¿por qué se puede ocupar el today, el this week, si no nos importa cuándo? Porque el hoy no ha terminado. O sea, todavía tenemos ahorita hora 50. La semana no ha terminado, tenemos más días. Entonces, sí puedes ocupar esos time frames.
Ah, ok.
Ahora, ¿podríamos ocupar mañana, tomorrow?
Ya sería futuro.
Muy bien, creería que no. Futuro. No se puede. Muy bien. ¿Podríamos ocupar yesterday?
Ayer. Según lo que le entendí, sí, porque ya pasó. Sería como la ventana de tiempo. ¿O no? Ah, no, porque ya iría, ya cambiaría en la oración. No se podría.
Muy bien, ya cambiaría pasado.
Ya cambiaría pasado.
Correcto, porque la ayer ya terminó. Entonces, ahí prácticamente tú ves, te estoy explicando, tratando, in a nutshell, eso es otro idioma, in a nutshell, es como así súper resumido,
in a nutshell.
Entonces, have you ever been on TV? Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Ahora, como si se puede mencionar cuántas veces, tú puedes decir, en la respuesta, luego de que tú decís sí o no, acordate que ya contestamos yes, I have, no, I haven't. Después de eso, tú puedes decir lo que quieras. Pero generalmente, el present perfect se ocupa mucho con pasado. ¿Ya? Porque si yo te pregunto, mira, tú ya has comido, tú ya has ido al ¿cómo se llama el lago de Coatepeque?
Lago de creo que así se llama Lake of Coatepeque, no sé.
Coatepeque Lake, ¿ya sí?
Ajá, Coatepeque Lake. Yes, I have.
¿Y qué te sale decirme después de eso?
I have going last weekend. sí, algo así.
Muy bien. Fui el fin de semana pasado, pero ahí tú ocupaste uh-huh. I have gone.
Uh-huh.
He ido sí. el fin de semana pasado, entonces ahí ya no pega. Si tú me quieres decir cuándo fuiste, ocupamos pasado. I went last weekend.
I went last weekend.
Uh-huh. Entonces eso es por lo que mucha gente se confunde.
Uh-huh.
Si tú me vas a decir cuándo, te pasas a simple past. Si no, okay. me puedes decir, he ido tres veces. I have gone there uh-huh. three times.
Three times. Uh-huh. Three times. Ok. Pues, sí, ahora sí, ya lo tengo más claro. Es que sí me había confundido esa parte. Y también eso le iba a preguntar porque había esa oración que le decía, uh-huh. I always, no recuerdo cómo era, pero sí llevaba como esa ventana de tiempo. Entonces ahí ya me había quedado la duda, pero ya con eso.
El I have always, uh-huh. I have always loved you. Bueno, nativa, es un ejemplo. Entonces, como si tú le decís a una persona, I have always loved you, siempre uh-huh. te he amado, uh-huh. significa que empezó un día en el que tú lo empezaste a amar,
pero no lo ha finalizado.
O la empezaste a amar, lo que sea,
ajá.
exacto, no ha finalizado. Entonces, sí, sí se pueden con I have never también, nunca he.
Nunca.
I have never gone to Puerto Rico, por ejemplo.
Que nunca he viajado.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Bueno, sería I have never been to. Nunca he estado en Puerto Rico. No es nunca he ido, nunca he estado. I have never been to Puerto Rico.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Pues, sí, ya. Ahora sí, ya.
Okay, good job. Sí. So, pretty sí. much in a nutshell, en 10 minutitos traté de explicarte el present perfect. Mm-hmm. Practicalo, sí. porque yes. esto es súper, súper, súper de los más usados.
Okay.
All right. Thank you very much for your dedication, Catherine. Have yourself a great night. I'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.